Sleeping again? Good lord. Well, anyway, here's a little story about a man named Snack. If we were on a train, he'd be at the next stop. He's a man with a heart, and I'm an ape. And if you're bored, in the intermission provides grapes. Enjoy the show as best as you can. I'll be the man to help you understand why rivers do flow. Just like stories, tune in with your ears, and here'll be the glory.
My name is Mark Israel. My films tend to include some form of so-called puppetry, and apparently this little film is no exception. I live with Barkley the cat. We get along pretty good. I also harvest, brew, and distribute a sweetened tea fermented by a solid mass of microorganisms called kombucha. Phenomenal World Kombucha, my company, claims our secret recipe can produce various kinds of small miracles.
That's kombucha smells nice. So we'll put the lid on, put the cheesecloth back on top.
Our adventures of this film begin when I was personally transporting a load of kombucha from my home in Northampton, Massachusetts, to Woodstock, New York.
Packed up and ready to go.
Last ride introduced himself as Snock.
I enjoy watching the Gene Autry movies. He always had these big fist fights where they're breaking chairs over each other's heads. And they always had like herds of bad guys on horseback chasing herds of good guys, or the other way around. No matter what's going on, Gene always gets to pull out his guitar and they all start singing.
Blooming in the patio.
I just met this guy, got a ride from him, and his name is Snock. That's what he said his name is. And he was a very interesting fellow. Great ride, great company. And apparently he's playing at this gallery. He's doing a sound check right now. I'm gonna go check in on him.
One of the devil's daughters. Hey, look at me with scorn. I'll never hear that horn.
He called himself Snock, but the billing read Michael Hurley and his band Ida. The judgmental mind is nasty. I first branded him a dime a dozen folk singer, but within minutes I heard a distinct, lucid voice roaring through his quiet music. I'd be back for a show, but had to take care of some business first.
Thanks for dropping off the kombucha.
No problem. Those songs Snock sang were piquing my curiosity. I think he's probably been around. It sounds like he's been playing guitar for 35 years or something. He said he has some albums out. And so I'm going to go look him up online at the library, if it's still open. Indeed, he had over 15 albums out. The first one recorded in 1965 on the same reel-to-reel machine that taped Lead Belly's last sessions.
Oh, you again? Well, we're about the body and energy and the way it reacts with the bodies of others. Do you understand? Okay, let's listen to some more.
Back at Varga Gallery, I took a front seat on the floor.
Everybody, huh? We won't be.
I was struck by the delicateness of this man's mouth, seduced into the lonesome valleys of these songs. Snock took a music break and introduced me to his old friend Paul McMahon.
Well, we were on the golf team in high school.
Mm-hmm. What kind of golfer was he?
He was pretty much par.
Mm-hmm.
I was a little subpar. As a matter of fact, he's a great magician, I think, because I think that if you like Satie music, you like that balance and that slow kind of almost like a drunk walk of like endless sophistication. It's very slapstick, but it's slapstick and slow and pretty at the same time, so it's yeah. Great. Break out the cups and the honeydew.
But you know anything about Michael Hurley? he's generally my favorite too, but back to the show.
There's a town someplace in, I believe it's in Pennsylvania. There's an old coal mine underneath the town, and it's on fire. And it's been on fire for 50 years. It cannot be put out. There is smoke coming up out of the ground in this town, and the real estate values were going down. He wanted to set up a guitar school in that town. That was his dream.
So,
well, I've been looking at this picture. The little mischievous imp has painted the spots on the cow.
That's what I was thinking of.
Snock and Paul invited me to stay with them for the night.
Oh, it's you.
I don't want to cure you of your problem. I think it's kind of cute.
Paul showed us old videotapes from his bygone days in the entertainment industry. My favorite was his giant potato routine.
We have a story tonight of a spud that's certainly no dud.
How you doing there?
Maury's the name.
Maury, that makes you a meat and potatoes man now, because you're meeting me. Yeah. Just putting a book out called Potato Jokes. They're going to love it. I tell you, people are going to eat this book up.
Potato jokes.
Peelings. All I have is peelings.
Hey, you sucker. What kind of jacketation is this on your phone? I don't understand. How sweet I roamed from field to field.
In the morning, I traded Snock a gallon of kombucha for 5 of his albums, then hitchhiked back home. I got in late, and there was this phone message from Snock, singing a poem by William Blake. Turns out that he and Paul spent the entire day swilling on kombucha. After Woodstock, I told Barkley the Cat about meeting Snock, and thus began our mutual intoxication. His albums began spinning in the apartment night and day, airing the place out. We discovered he's a truly great recording artist and could hear the influence wide and clear. He'd obviously dragged a fine-tined rake across the whole of old American music. He mixed himself in with this rich soil and emerged as Snock, a self-made musician living and singing his own life, like a meteor with zero control over where it's going because it's just going. Barkley and I especially love to dance to Blue Navigator.
Blue Navigator, which course did you chart? I'm going to New York City. That's where I left my heart. That's where I left my heart.
I began learning more about Snock's life, how he dropped out of high school to hitchhike across the country, hop trains and even rob trains, crisscrossed the continent for 40 years, performing thousands of gigs, while at the same time taking a steaming, smiling shit on a music career, fame, and the rat race. Nevertheless, each of his many records is as unwavering and exquisite as the first, and each album cover chock full of his own artwork.
Oh, the werewolf, oh, the werewolf comes stepping along. He don't even break the branches where he's been gone. You can hear his long holler from way across the moon. That's the holler of the werewolf when he's feeling.
He lived all over the map, worked as a car mechanic, apple picker, hot tamale street vendor, Christmas tree seller, shop sweeper, 8-track tape player repairman, all the while collecting old cars, raising a mess of kids, and making music with his friends. His songs, full of lonely cries, love chatter, and good cheer, felt like medicine for my weary soul. His words establish a deep sense of harmony with his direct surroundings, often evoking the animals and landscapes of the natural world. And this harmony is contagious, especially when married to those sweet melodies. When I added his comics to the mix, it was like a full-scale medicine show in my own living room.
Oh, my stars, how you undo me. Oh, my stars, oh my stars, you undo me.
Everything is
I want to give you a true taste of Snock, but Snock won't work too well in snippets. Each song is like a film you must see from start to finish for the full story. And each track is so different from the last, with the humor piling up as you listen. You probably need a whole album to have the Snock spirit hit you between the eyes. He's not like anybody, and there's nothing like him. Nothing.
I don't want to live in Twilight Zone.
How did I never hear of this man before? He's been a great inspiration on many a musician, including singer Cat Power, who's recorded several of his songs. Hell, his 1976 album with the Unholy Modal Rounders was declared Album of the Year by the Village Voice.
She ran up the hill, she cried and cried. I run down the other side. Oh, sweet Lucy. Oh, sweet Lucy. Oh, sweet Lucy, let me go.
Man, Snack is a hell of a singer. But maybe I could do better. Let's see. I am in the front of a beautiful parade. And I have no care for litmus tests. I'm the best scientist without equipment. I just jump in my Jeep and ride to Britain. See? Well, what do you got, Michael?
Hey, Mark. Mark, over in Everest. You're going to, my gig over in Somerville tomorrow? Or what are you doing today? And here we go.
He was 6 miles away, inviting me to his Boston show.
Holy is as holy as is holy.
I didn't really know if Snock wanted my company or simply wanted more kombucha. You see, Phenomenal World kombucha orders began to grow significantly as he spread the word around those past weeks. He claimed he got rid of his athlete's foot and improved his singing voice, among other things. But whatever the reason, the next day we drove, drinking kombucha and singing Fats Domino songs aloud in the car.
Biking area.
You bike around, you have a bike?
I used to bike around here. Yeah, I have two bikes. I had a car, but it was hell to drive the car. That stressed me out. I couldn't keep up with the traffic and all that. Cornbread's apartment is right there. It's Cornbread's apartment.
Who's Cornbread? I keep on hearing that name.
At least it's mutant guy.
He's what?
It's a mutant.
Oh. See the one? Sometimes the question is asked, if you could meet up with any person alive or dead throughout history, who would it be? For me, it was Michael Hurley.
Hey, Snack, how are you? Good to see you.
Jocko, you jack off too much. You'll wear the bone to a frazzle.
Snock was in very giddy form, apparently due to all the kombucha we drank.
Something's going on.
He's got something going on.
Snock, snock, kombucha.
Meet my friend, Mark here.
My encounters with Snock have confirmed so many things I've been slowly knowing. The best music is always homespun, like the time you heard Grandpa crooning from across the hall. We trap ourselves willingly with ideas derived from television, preachers, yoga teachers, politicians, parents. But some find their own code, and like Snock's werewolves, they'll never fit in anywhere. And by not fitting in, they fit better than the rest. Perhaps we're all like Cornbread the Mutant, grounded by gravity, but still strange and extraterrestrial to ourselves. I've always liked hitchhiking because you have no idea what will happen next. I'm glad I still do it sometimes. Otherwise, I'd have never met Snock.
When we make spaghetti, everybody gathers round and they eat it by the pound. When we make spaghetti, everybody gathers round and they eat it by the pound. They all gather round. We fill up our guts, then we turn it into shit, then we get rid of it. We fill up our guts, then we turn it into shit, then we get rid of it.